أهلا وسهلا بالجميع. محاضرتنا اليوم بعنوان Estimation of Parameters. The field of statistical inference consists of those methods used to make decisions or to draw conclusions about a population. These methods utilize the information contained in a random sample taken from the population in drawing conclusions. فالجنرال سيت اب للمسألة اللي بدنا نعالجها, we have a population with a certain probability density function f sub x of x, and there are certain numbers or parameters that need to be estimated. These parameters are unknown, and in order to get an idea about these parameters, we draw a random sample from this population. This sample, random sample, is of size xn. فاللي بنعمله, we analyze the sample and draw the conclusions from the sample and try to apply these conclusions to the original population. These methods utilize the information contained in a random sample taken from the population in drawing conclusions regarding the population itself. لأنه الـ population is so large, ما بنقدر نحصل على كل الخصائص تبعته, ولا بنقدر نعرف كل الـ members اللي فيه زي ما راح نشوف كمان شوية, لكن بنقدر نحصل على فكرة كويسة عن الـ population بإنه بنحلل الـ random sample اللي عندنا اللي هي of size x of size n. من الترمز اللي عندنا, we have what is called the population. The population consists of all conceivable items, observations, or measurements in a group. In most cases, it's not practical to obtain all the measurements in a given population. مثلا, eligible voters, the unemployed, people below poverty line, Birzeit University students, high school teachers. These are the populations. These are the populations with unknown features. فمن الصعب إن نحصي ونعرف كل الخصائص كل الأعضاء الموجودين في هذا في هاي ال population. For example, على سبيل المثال, suppose we need to find the average height and the standard deviation of the university male and female students. The population here is all university students. It's evident that to get exact results, we need to take the height of all students and compute the average and the standard deviation. Okay, these are the population parameters. يعني مثلا في عنا في الجامعة في عنا 14,000 طالب, في منهم 70% طالبات, وفي عنا 30% طلاب. فبدنا نعرف الـ average height للطالبات والطلاب. فإذا نحط السؤال بهذا الشكل, بيعني أنه لازم نقيس الأطوال كلها exactly لكل طلاب الجامعة, لكل طالبات الجامعة, ومنها بنحسب المين وبنحسب الستاندرد ديفيشن. يعني لو واحد من الطلاب كان غايب أو طالبة, ما بنقدر أن النتيجة اللي بنحصل عليها بتكونش نتيجة دقيقة, لأنه ما أخذنا بالاعتبار كل الممبرز اللي موجودين في البوبوليشن. بس مش هيك الطريقة. فبالعادة زي ما بنحكي, يعني إنه هذا الحكي صعب جدا إنه ينعمل. فبالتالي الطريقة اللي بنتنعمل بالستاتيستكس هي التالي. In practice, a random sample of size n is drawn from the university population. The height of the selected students are taken, and then the mean and standard deviation of the sample are calculated. The sample mean and standard deviation are used to describe the actual mean and the standard deviation of the population. يعني بدل ما ناخذ كل الطالبات وكل الطلاب, بناخذ عينه. هاي العينه لنفرض بدنا ناخذ مثلا 200 طالب, او بدنا ناخذ 100 طالب. بنوجد الأطوال للميتين طالب أو للميت طالب, وبنحسب الأفرج وبنحسب الستاندرد ديفيشن, وبنقول هدول النتائج اللي حصلنا عليها هي عبارة عن indicative للactual parameters للdistribution. Estimates of population parameters you derived from the subset of the measurements in a sample drawn from the underlying population are called sample statistics. فهنا بتيجي فكرة الستاتيستكس أو السامبل ستاتيستكس، إنه إحنا كل التحليلات اللي بنعملها بنعملها على السامبل، فهي سامبل ستاتيستكس. وما بنعمل إحنا في الستاتيستكس تحليلات بتتعلق في البوبوليشن كله، فكل التحليلات بتكون هي على الراندم سامبل اللي أخذناها، فهي اسمها سامبل ستاتيستكس. Statistical inference may be divided into two major areas, parameter estimation and hypothesis testing. In this chapter, we focus on parameter estimation and consider hypothesis testing in the next chapter. For populations, we define numbers. These numbers called parameters, theta 1 and theta 2. These are parameters that characterize important properties of the distribution, يعني like the mean and standard deviation of a normal distribution. We know that a normal distribution is fully characterized by its mean and its variance. The probability of a success in a binomial distribution, the rate of arrival in the Poisson process, and the endpoints A and B of the uniform distribution. These are all important features of a population, and these important features are called the parameters. فإذا إحنا ما بنعرف هذول الparameters، وبالعادة يعني in statistics we don't know these parameters، فزي ما قلنا حتى نقدر ناخد فكرة عن هاي الparameters بناخد random sample and we analyze this sample and draw conclusions regarding these unknown parameters. Estimation, شو بتعني الاستيميشن؟ Estimation represents ways or processes of learning and determining the population parameters based on the model fitted to the data. So this is our data, this is our sample, this is our random sample. We analyze the sample. And analysis of the sample or results of sampling or results of analyzing the sample are called estimation. So we estimate theta 1 based on some function of the measurement. We estimate theta 2 based on a measure based on a function of the measurement. So لكل واحد من هذول الparameters we need to find an appropriate function f. This is the model to be fitted. So we are looking for the best function f and the best function g that can approximate theta 1 cap to theta 1 and theta 2 cap to theta 2. فبندور على ايش الاحسن شيء، احسن function f و g، بحيث انه النتائج اللي تعطينا اياها لما نعوض في القيم تبعت الميجرمنتس في الفانكشن f والفانكشن g تعطينا احسن او اقرب نتائج لثيتا 1 ولثيتا 2. من الاستيميشن او البارامترز اوف البارامتر استيميشن، بوينت استيميشن، انترفال استيميشن، اند هايبوثيسيس تيستينج. ففي البارامتر استيميشن وي هاف تو تايبس اوف استيميشن، بوينت استيميشن اند انترفال استيميشن، اند هايبوثيسيس تيستينج ار 3 مين ويز اوف ليرنينج اباوت ذا بوبوليشن بارامتر from the sample statistics. زي ما رح نشوف على السلايد الجاي. نحكي شوية على الـ point estimation. In point estimation, we estimate the unknown parameter using a single number that is calculated from the sample data. So we have a function, f of x1, x2, up to xn. And when we plug in the values for x1, x2, and xn, we end up with one numerical value for theta cap called the estimate of theta. وهي, this is just a number. مثلا, point estimation of the university students, the point estimate for the height of students based on the random sample would be a number like 175 centimeters for male students and 165 centimeters for female students. يعني بنيجي زي ما قلنا من شوية بنحلل أو بناخد العينة الأطوال تبعت الميتين طالب وبناخد العينات أو الأطوال تبع الميت طالب بنستعمل هاي الفونكشن بالنهاية when we plug in numbers for the height of male students in this formula we end up with a number this number is 175 centimeters and when we plug in numbers for the heights of the 200 female students we end up again with just one number and this number is 165 which is the estimate this is the estimate for the female student heights فهاي اللي هي ال point estimation now in interval estimation we estimate the unknown parameter using an interval of values that is likely to contain the true value of the parameter and state how confident we are that this interval indeed captures the true value of the parameter. بدنا نتذكر دائما انه this parameter is unknown and so theoretically it might be anywhere between minus infinity to infinity. In point estimation, احنا بنحدد we just identify one point along the theta axis. بالانترفال استيميشن احنا بنحدد انترفال theta 1 and theta 2 وبنقول انه we are for example 95% confident that the true parameter falls within this interval. فكمان مرة بالنسبة لطلاب الجامعة we may say that the probability that the height of male students falls between 173 centimeters and 177 centimeter is greater than 0.95 لاحظين انه في عنا هنا confident مش بس انا بحدد نقطة واحدة بدون ما اربطها زي ال point estimation بربطها ب confidence لا هنا انا بحدد end points theta 1 and theta 2 وبربطهم في probability so I am 95% confident that the true parameter falls between theta 1 and theta 2 فبدنا نحدد هدول ال end points theta 1 و theta 2 بس انتبهوا انه these are different from these theta 1 and theta 2 these are the population parameters and these are points along the theta axis بس حتى يعني don't confuse the notation. In hypothesis testing, we begin with a claim about the population, usually called the null hypothesis, and we check whether or not the data obtained from the sample provide evidence in favor or against this claim. يعني نعطي رقم بالنسبة لثيتا 1 أو لثيتا 2 والآن الداتا اللي جمعناها the data which we gather will either support our claim or it does not support it. So the hypothesis testing test the null hypothesis that the height of male students is 175 centimeters versus the alternative hypothesis that the height is greater than 175 centimeters. يعني بنبدأ بافتراض بنقول انه اطوال الطلاب في الجامعة هو 175 سنتيمتر. هل الحكي هذا صح ولا خطأ؟ نقدر نحكي بهذا الشكل. وبنقدر نحكي كمان السؤال بشكل آخر، هل أطوال الطلاب الجامعة 175 سنتيمتر ولا أكثر؟ هل أطوال الطلاب 175 سنتيمتر ولا أقل؟ فهاي هي يعني بنبدأ بستيتمنت، بتتعلق في البارامتر، وبعدين بناء على الداتا اللي بنجمعها يا إما بنكون in favor في هذا الكليم أو against that claim. فإذا ال point estimation it is just a single numerical value along the theta axis. However the interval estimation relates the interval within which the parameter may fall with a confidence, with a probability that the true parameter will fall within a certain interval. الآن بنعود بنعيد الكلام بس بنحطه بشكل formal أكتر. So formal definitions and terminology. In statistics, we take a set of n independent measurements, x1, x2, up to xn of size n from a distribution x for which the probability density function is f sub x of theta 1 and theta 2 by performing that experiment n times. We should point out that these measurements should be independent. Otherwise, the results will not be accurate. The results will be biased. فبالتالي كل ما كانت الميجرمنتس اللي بناخدها random أكتر وبحيث إنه الميجرمنتس اللي بناخدها independent, our results will be more accurate, will not be biased. So عشان هيك we are highlighting this independent assumption. So we are performing that experiment n times. بمعنى we are drawing n measurements from the population. The population has certain parameters theta 1 and theta 2 which we need to estimate. The random variables x1, x2, up to xn called a random sample have the same distribution f of x, theta 1, theta 2, and are assumed to be independent. Since all x1, x2 are drawn from the same population, so the properties of the population also apply to each one of these sampled measurements. يعني if f of x is an exponential distribution with parameter lambda, then x1 is an exponential distribution with parameter lambda, x2 is an exponential distribution with parameter lambda, xn is also an exponential distribution with parameter lambda. أيضا, if f of x is a Gaussian distribution with a given mean and variance, then x1 is also Gaussian with the same mean and variance. x2 is also a Gaussian random variable with mean mu x and variance sigma x and so on. So all these measurements have the same distribution. All of them have the same distribution and are assumed to be independent. مرة تانية احنا بنحكي على الindependence among the random sample. هلا الindependence in terms of the density functions also means that the joint probability density function of the n independent random variables equal the product of the marginal probability density function. Usually we know, طبعا كلهم هدول they have the same marginal density function, and so The joint density function of the n independent random variables is the product of the marginal probability density functions. Now, مرة تانية, the purpose is to draw conclusions, from the properties of the sample about properties of the distribution of the corresponding X or the population. هاي طبعا حكيناها سابقا, وهي بتفسر اصلا ليش why we are taking a random sample. We are taking a random sample in order to analyze the sample and draw conclusions about the population from properties of the random sample. So, مرة تانية, for populations we define the numbers which we call parameters, theta 1 and theta 2, denoted theta 1 and theta 2, that characterize important properties of the distributions. Here, the probability density function is expressed explicitly in terms of the parameters as f sub x of theta 1 and theta 2. These parameters are unknown. مرة تانية, we emphasize that we do not know the actual or the true values of the population parameters. وكل الفكرة من الاستيميشن وكل الفكرة من هذا الشابتر انه نلاقي الطرق اللي نقدر نحصل على قيم تقديرية لثيتا 1 وثيتا 2. So in general, these parameters are unknown. The unknown parameters theta 1 and theta 2 are estimated by some appropriate function of the observations. So we have some function theta 1 cap of x1, x2 up to xn. The second parameter is estimated using a different function g of x1, x2 up to xn. This is the estimator. This is called, this is what we call a statistic or estimator, and this is what we call a statistic or estimator. Both of them are functions of the measurements. The function theta cap equal f of x1, x2 up to xn of the observable sample data that is used to estimate the unknown population parameter is called a statistic or an estimator. A particular value of the estimator is called an estimate. So the estimator is a function. We express it in terms of, explicitly in terms of the measurements x1, x2, up to xn. لما نعمل actual experiment and we collect measurements, we substitute these numerical values into f and obtain a value. The numerical value which we obtain is called the estimate of theta. فالاستيميتر, الاستيميتر, الاستيميتر هو عبارة عن الفانكشن. The estimate is the numerical value which we obtain after substituting the numerical values of the measurements into the function f. A probability distribution of a statistic is called the sampling distribution. The sampling distribution f sub theta cap of theta cap. طبعا يعني we need to elaborate a little bit on this statement. X1, X2 up to Xn are random variables. These are random variables, and any function of random variables is also a random variable. So f is a random variable. Theta cap is also a random variable. And for a random variable, there exists a probability density function. Okay? The probability density function of this random variable, theta cap, is called the sampling distribution. يعني, the probability density function of the function of the sampled data. So x1, x2 up to xn are random variables. Any function of a random variable is also a random variable. Theta cap is a random variable and it has a probability density function. That density function is called the sampling distribution. We consider two types of parameter estimation, point estimation and interval estimation. زي ما حكينا سابقا. Examples of parameters, زي ما شفنا سابقا, height of male and female university students, the percentage of smokers among high school students, the compression strength of concrete, the percentage of students who favor e-learning techniques. مثلا زي ما حكينا انه the height of male and female students. هون حتى نحصل على الاكزاكت فاليو لازم ناخذ اطوال كل طلاب وكل طالبات الجامعه ونعمل statistics عليهم. هذا الحكي طبعا مستحيل، وبالتالي من المنطق اكثر ان نروح ندرس random sample، وبناء على الراندوم sample يعني نستنتج نتائج بتتعلق في البوبوليشن. The percentage of smokers among high school students. هلا حدا في علم الاجتماع بده يشوف انه طلاب المدارس قديش النسبة المئوية بيناتهم اللي بيدخنوا. فطبعا مستحيل مستحيل ولا حدا في الدنيا بيقدر يعرف قديش هاي النسبة، لانه في ناس بتدخن بتاع اصحابها بيعرف عنها، اهاليهم بيعرفوش عنهم، فهذا الرقم مجهول. ففي واحد من علم الاجتماع بده يعمل هاي الدراسة، فمفروض انه يلف على عدد من المدارس المختلفة ويختار السامبل تبعته الميجرمنتس بشكل اندبندنت ويوجد هاي النسبة. ياخذ له 1000 طالب من 20 30 مدرسة مختلفة موزعين في مناطق مختلفة، ويشوف من الألف طالب اللي سألهم مثلا كم واحد فيهم بدخن. فهاي الطريقة اللي بنقدر نحصل فيها على استيميت للأنون باراميتر. نفس الشيء the compression strength of concrete, the percentage of students who favor e-learning techniques. كلهم بيشتركوا في شيء واحد، انه الـ actual او الـ true percentage او الـ true parameter is unknown and it's impossible to obtain. فبالتالي الطريقة الوحيدة اللي نحصل فيها على قيم معقولة هي ان نعمل او ناخد random sample، نحلل الـ random sample وبناء على الـ random sample نعمل استنتاجات بتتعلق في الـ population. بنحكي شوية الآن عن الـ point estimator أو الـ point estimation. Point estimation involves the use of the sample data to calculate a single value which is to serve as the best guess for the unknown parameter. In other words, a point estimate of some unknown parameter theta is a single numerical value. Here we have the population. The population is characterized by a probability density function f of x, theta 1 and theta 2. These are the population parameters. These are unknown parameters and we need to estimate these parameters. The procedure, we take a random sample of size n. We take a random sample of size n from this population. These observations are assumed to be independent and identically distributed random variables. Independent is a must condition in sampling to ensure unbiasedness, identically distributed because they are members of this population. Then we define some function f of the measurements, theta 1 cap, and we define another function to estimate the second parameter, theta 2, another function of the measurements, the same measurements, of course. فبيطلع لنا الاستيميتر. This is called the estimator. After we substitute numerical values for the measurements x1 up to xn and x1 up to xn in this function, we obtain single numerical values. These single numerical values are called the point estimate or a point estimator of the theta 1 and theta 2. هاي هي الـ point estimate. This is the theta axis. قلنا انه الـ actual population parameter is unknown فممكن ياخد اي قيمة على الـ x axis. However, in point estimation, after we plug in the measurements into the function, we end up with some or with one numerical value along the theta axis. So the estimator theta cap is a random variable. This theta and this theta is a random variable with a sampling distribution f sub theta of theta. بما انه x1, x2 up to xn, these are random variables زي ما حكيت سابقا, then theta cap is also a random variable, and any random variable has a probability density function. This density function is called the sampling distribution. This estimator, الآن بدنا نشوف إنه هاي الفانكشن, this function, this estimator should have certain desirable properties that makes it close to the true value in a probabilistic sense. يعني ما رح, يعني الهدف تبعنا, الهدف تبعنا إنه الاستيميتر اللي بنختاره يعطينا تقدير جيد عن القيمة الحقيقية. يعني هذا هو المطلوب. فإحنا بنترجم هاي الكلمة إنه بدنا ثيتا كاب يكون قريب جدا من ثيتا بإنه لازم تتوفر في مجموعة من الخصائص. الأولى it should be unbiased. على الصفحة الجاي بنعرف شو يعني unbiased estimator. تانية should have a small variance. بما إنه random variable فإله mean و variance. So the mean should be unbiased. The variance should have a small variance and should have a small mean square error. These properties are considered next. على الصفحة الجاي واللي بعدها بنحكي أكثر عن خصائص الـ point estimator. بس هاي هي الثلاث خصائص المهمة. إنه the estimator, this random variable should be unbiased. The variance of this random variable should be small. And the mean square error, which is the difference between theta cap and the true value, should be very, very small. What do we mean by unbiased estimator? بشكل عام, these are desirable properties of point estimators. An estimator should be close to the true value of the unknown parameter. هاي الجملة العامة. Definition. A point estimator theta cap is unbiased estimator of theta if expected value of theta cap equal to theta. الآن زي ما حكينا من شوية theta cap is a random variable. This is a random variable, and so we need the mean value or the expected value of this random variable to be equal to the true population parameter theta. So this is the first condition. إنه الاستيميتر should be unbiased. بمعنى إنه the mean or average or expected value of this random variable should equal the true population parameter theta. الآن الفرق. If the estimator is biased, if this does not equal to this, the difference, which is the expected value of theta cap minus theta, expected value of theta cap minus theta, equal to B, this is called the bias of the estimator. يعني there is an offset in the expected value of this function. إحنا بنحب إنه هاي الفانكشن المين فاليو إلها يساوي الترو بارامتر. لكن في بعض الأحيان there could be an offset or a difference between the expected value of the estimator and the true value. The difference is called the bias of the estimator. الآن في عنا كمان خاصية تانية بتتعلق بالvariance للrandom variable theta cap. Suppose we have two estimators theta A and theta B cap for this parameter theta. Someone proposed two estimators, estimator A and estimator B. Be two unbiased estimators of theta. A logical principle of estimation when selecting among several candidate estimators is to choose the one that has the minimum variance. So we have two candidate, we have two candidate estimators for the unknown parameter theta. Both of these candidates are unbiased. Both of them are unbiased. بضل السؤال, which one of them to select? The logical answer is we select the one with the smaller variance. Okay? So we choose the one with the smaller variance. Definition, if we consider all unbiased estimators of theta, the one with the smallest variance is called the minimum variance unbiased estimator. الآن في هذا المثال, we were comparing just two estimators, theta A and theta B. If we have many candidate estimators, many candidate estimators for the same parameter theta, the one with the smallest variance is called the minimum variance unbiased estimator. يعني when we compare two, we choose the one with the smaller variance. If we have many candidate estimators, we choose the one with the minimum variance, and that one is called the minimum variance unbiased estimator. The minimum variance unbiased estimator. So, in conclusion, when the variance of theta A is smaller than theta B, we choose the one with the smaller variance, and that one is called more efficient than theta B. Okay? فال comparison is just, this is a terminology that refers to a comparison between the variances. The one with the smaller variance is called more efficient than theta B. So we recall that the variance of any random variable is the expected value of that random variable minus the mean value of that random variable. This is a measure of the imprecision of the estimator, a measure of the spread of data around the mean value. يعني بنيجي, if the variance is smaller, this means that the data which we collect and use this function is more concentrated around the mean value than around this mean value. بمعنى انه يعني درجة الدقة اللي حصلنا عليها لما يكون الفاريانس أصغر هي أحسن من درجة الدقة اللي حصلنا عليها لما استعملنا الاستيميتر الثاني. بشكل عام نقدر إن يعني نحكي عن الإفشنسي أو نحكي عن جودة الاستيميتر مش بس بدلالة إنه unbiased أو minimum variance, إنما بنقدر نعبر عنه بشكل عام بدلالة المين سكوير ايرور. So the mean square error of an estimator theta cap of the parameter theta is defined as the mean square error equal the expected value. Theta cap is the estimator and theta is the true parameter. This is the mean square error, theta cap minus theta. هلا بتصير المسألة إنه we will be looking for some function theta cap which minimizes the mean square error. This is called the minimum mean square error estimator. The minimum mean square error estimator. That is the estimator which minimizes the mean square error. The mean square error is just the expected value between the expected value of the estimator minus the true mean. The minimum mean square error estimator is that estimator which minimizes the expected value, this expected value. This measure of goodness takes into account both the bias and the imprecision, meaning the mean and the variance. The mean square error can be expressed as, نشوفه بشكل آخر حتى نربطه مع السلايد السابقة. The mean square error is just the expected value of theta cap الآن we add and subtract the expected value of theta cap. هاي theta الأصلية theta cap and this is theta. So we add and subtract the expected value of theta cap. طبعا ما بيأثر. Then we group this theta cap minus its mean value and expected value of theta cap minus theta, expected value of theta cap minus theta, وبنعرف انه the expected value of theta cap minus theta, this is just the bias. This is just the bias. So the mean square error, the mean square error is the expected value of this quantity square of this quantity square. فبناخد الترم الأول بنربعه. This is the expected value of theta cap minus expected value of theta square plus twice b, this b, times the expected value of theta cap minus the expected value of theta cap plus expected value of this quantity square. And this quantity is a constant, which is b, and so the result is b square. This b square. فبنيجي لهذا الترم. Expected value of theta cap. Expected value of theta cap is a constant. In general, this does not equal to theta unless we have an unbiased estimator. And the expected value of theta cap. Expected value of theta cap minus the expected value of theta cap, this becomes zero. لأنه بنضل ناخد expected value لنفس الكمية مرة بنجمعها ومرة بنطرحها, so the result is zero. Therefore, the mean square error in general equal the variance of the estimator, plus the bias square. هلا إذا كان الاستيميتر اللي عندنا unbiased estimator, فالmean square error is just the variance of that estimator. بس هاي النتيجة. فإذا كنا متمشكلين يعني عندنا estimator مش unbiased والvariance تبعه, فالcriterion بتكون إن بندور على الاستيميتر with the smaller mean square error. The smaller mean square error. يمكن يكون في bias, يمكن الفيرينس يعبروا التنين عن بعض, بس بالنهاية إحنا إذا تمشكلنا وفي biasness والفيرينس بندور على الاستيميتر with the smaller mean square error. And finally, an estimator whose variance and bias go to zero as the number of observations goes to infinity is called consistent estimator. طبعا في بعض الاستيميترز اللي القيمة تبعتهم is quite يعني slow in converging to zero. في بعضهم بيكونوا أسرع الconvergence للزيرو. فالاستيميتر مفروض إنه كل ما زاد حجم العينة اللي بناخدها, كل ما هدول الفروقات سواء الفيريانس ولا البايسنس التنين البايس او الفيريانس التنين يروحوا للصفر, لانه مفروض انه يعني الاكيورسي تزيد مع زيادة عدد الميجرمنتس. فبالتالي من الافضل انه نختار او نكبر العينة بحيث انه نقلل من المين سكوير ايرور ونصغر من الفيريانس ونصغر من البايسنس, وبالتالي النتيجة انه when both the variance and the mean value or the bias goes to zero as n goes to infinity, this is called a consistent estimator. في هذا المثال بنحاول نوضح بعض الافكار اللي شرحناها في هذا الشابتر. Let x1 and x2 be two random samples, be a random sample of size 2, from a population with mean mu x and variance sigma x squared. Two estimators for the mean mu x are proposed, mu 1 cap equal x1 plus x2 over 2, and mu 2 cap equal x1 plus 2x2 over 3. We're estimating just one parameter, which is the mean value. وفي عنا two functions. الفunction الأولى اللي بتقول we take the measurements x1 and x2, add them, divide by 2. الاستيميتر الثاني بيقول we take the first measurement and twice the second measurement and divide by 3. فالسؤال تبعنا which estimator is better and in what sense؟ يعني إذا حدا سألك which of these two functions you prefer to estimate the unknown parameter mu x. Mu x is unknown. We have two candidate. We have two candidate functions. We have two candidate functions that estimate mu x. Which one is better and in what sense? فإن اللوجيك بدنا نجرب نحل بالطريقة اللي تعلمناها. First, we check for the unbiasedness of the two estimators. بناخذ الاستيميتر الاولاني. We need to check what is the expected value, what is the expected value of this estimator, mu1 cap. It's the expected value of x1 plus x2. الان this equals 1 half. What is the expected value of x1? x1 is a measurement taken from a population with mean mu x and variance sigma x square. Therefore, the mean value of x1 is the same as the mean value of the distribution from which it is sampled. Expected value of x2. Expected value of x2. X2 is also drawn from the same population with mean mu x and variance sigma x square. So its mean value is mu x. Then, expected value of mu 1 cap equal mu x plus mu x over 2 equal mu x. Therefore, mu 1 cap is an unbiased estimator of mu x. فبالتالي حسبنا الأولاني طلع مثل ما بدنا. يعني this is what we need. We need the expected value of the estimator to be equal to the true parameter. Then the bias B1 equal, which is the expected value of mu1 cap minus mu1 equal to zero. So there is no bias. ناخذ الاستيميتر الثاني. The expected value of mu2 cap equal expected value of x1 plus 2x2 over 3. So it's 1 third. The expected value of x1 is mu x. The expected value of x2 is also mu x. So we have 2 mu x over 3. 3 mu x over 3 equal mu x. Therefore, mu2 cap is also an unbiased estimator of mu x. يعني هدول two estimators, both of them are unbiased estimators. So the second bias, which is expected value of mu2 minus mu2 equal to zero. Both estimators are unbiased. Now we evaluate the variance of each one of these two estimators. بدنا نوجد ال variance للاستيميتر الأول وال variance للاستيميتر الثاني. Now we need to evaluate. So the variance of mu1. And the variance of 1 half x1 plus 1 half x2. بدنا نتذكر كيف كنا نوجد ال variance ل ax1 plus bx2. وهي النتيجة. This is 1 fourth. هذا الكوفيشن تبع x1 square. 1 fourth sigma 1 square. Plus 1 fourth sigma x2 square. طبعا بنشوف انه since these two random variables are independent, they are also uncorrelated. They are also uncorrelated, and the correlation coefficient equal to zero. وعلى هذا السبب فيش عندنا الترم اللي هو 2 A1 A2 sigma 1 sigma 2 times the correlation coefficient. فبما إنهم independent فالcorrelation coefficient equal to zero والvariance بتساوي sum of variances. فإذا 1/4 sigma x square plus 1/4 sigma x square equal 1/2 sigma x square. Okay, زي ما قلت إنه these two random variables x1 and x2 both of them have the same mean and the same variance. نيجي بنوجد ال variance للاستيميتر الثاني بنفس الطريقة variance of x1 plus 2x2 over 3 equal 1/9. This is 1/3. This is the coefficient of x1. فبتصير a1 square sigma square plus A2 square sigma 2 square. فالcoefficient 1/3 بصير 1/9 sigma square وهي بتصير 4/9 sigma x square. Again, x1 and x2 are independent, so their correlation coefficient equal to 0. والجواب 5/9 sigma square. الآن we have two estimators. Both of these two estimators are unbiased. However, the variance of the first estimator is smaller than the variance of the second estimator. Since 1/2 sigma x square is less than 5/9 sigma x 5/9 sigma x square, the first estimator is more efficient. طبعا كمان وبيعطينا the first estimator yields a smaller mean square error. Okay, لأنه التنتين unbiased estimator وبالتالي المين سكوير ايرور للاستيميتر الأول أفضل من المين سكوير ايرور للاستيميتر الثاني. So the mean square error of the first estimator equal the variance of mu 1 plus b1 square. B1 equal to 0, so equal 1/2 sigma x square. The mean square error of the second estimator equal the variance of mu 2 square plus b2 square. طبعا second bias is also equal to 0, so equal 5/9. Therefore, the mean square error of the first estimator is smaller than the mean square error of the second estimator. يعني the second estimator, the first estimator is more efficient. The first estimator is more efficient. It also yields a smaller mean square error. هلأ بنشوف probability density function of the first estimator and the second estimator. This is the first estimator. Its mean value is mu, so it's an unbiased estimator. This is the second estimator. Its mean value is theta. However, the variance of the small of the first estimator is smaller. وشو معنى الفاريانس؟ الفاريانس هو درجة. It's a measure of the spread of the data. So from this we observe that using the first estimator provides a better judgment about the value of the unknown parameter. لأنه القيم تبعتنا مركزة أكثر حوالين المين فاليو. The second estimator has a larger variance, بيعني إنه الداتا تبعته موزعة أكثر. In terms of precision, the first estimator is more precise. It's more precise. The second estimator is less precise than the first one. Precision بيعني إنه الفاريشن تبعت الداتا أو الاستيميتر تبعنا عن المين فاليو أقل كتير من الفاريشن تبعت الاستيميتر الثاني. وبالتالي هاي هي المنطقة اللي إحنا بندور فيه على ليش بندرس المين وليش بندرس الفاريانس. So these are typical sampling distributions of the statistic depending on the function which we choose. We choose this function, we choose this function. لو كان في عنا كمان واحدة تانية بندور عليها وبنختار اللي بتعطينا the smallest variance. Footnote, for more examples on point estimators, four more examples on point estimators are fully explained in the next lecture entitled Examples on Point Estimators. فهي بس example واحد بنوضح فيه the point estimation. في عنا مجموعة أكثر من كيف بندرس الخصائص المختلفة للpoint estimators, وهذا الحكي هو محور المحاضرة القادمة. هاي نهاية المحاضرة, إلى اللقاء.